Welcome to The Pro Tip. I'm Aaron. Today's pro tip comes to us as a request from a number of our users who are concerned about the Meltdown and Spectre chip vulnerabilities. They want to know, how does this affect the system that I'm running my Nagios implementation on? The short answer is, you need to update that system, just like you need to update all of the systems that are running all of the software in your environment. You need to update the system that your Nagios implementation is running on. That's what we're going to cover in this video, so let's jump into the terminal. All right, we're not going to be in the Nagios XI interface. We're going to be under the hood in the terminal. Now, the good news with Nagios XI is we only support two operating systems. The first is Red Hat Enterprise Linux, and the second is the community clone of that, the Community Enterprise Operating System, otherwise known as CentOS. Now, I'm going to use my preferred terminal. I run the OVA version of Nagios XI, so I'm going to use the console in the ESX interface. If you need to connect from a Windows workstation, you could use PuTTY, or from a Mac OS X or a Linux box, you can SSH to your Nagios XI instance. Depending on what you have, I have a system here that I've retained as default, so when I want to log in, my login is going to be root, and then the default password is listed. You'll see it up here in the banner. It says Nagios XI. Now I'm in. Here is the simple thing. That's all you have to do is you got to type yum update dash y, and then you hit enter, and it is going to take care of everything that you need to do from there. If you're running Nagios Core, check with your distribution that you are running your Nagios on and figure out what the correct update is going to be. Make sure you reboot so the update takes effect. Do you have a pro tip that you'd like to share? Please share that with us in the comments below this video, and don't forget to subscribe so that every time we put up a new pro tip, you're sure to get it. We'll talk to you soon.